Hey there, thank you for tuning into Duck Bricks. I'm Chris and welcome to a new episode of Breaking News Analysis, where I take a closer look at some of the breaking news that just was released last week. So last week, LEGO finally pulled back the curtain on some of the details regarding the partnership with LEGO Ideas and Bricklink to produce some past rejected LEGO ideas. One of these ideas is, as most of you probably watching this video know, the Bionicle set which Sokoda designed, which was a diorama set featuring some of the main key elements of the Bionicle G1 storyline. From Matoro's sacrifice to Tahu's arrival on the beach to the climactic final battle between Matanui and Makuta, a lot of these pivotal moments have been depicted in a very well-designed diorama-like object. Now, at the time of making the video, I literally recorded it right when the first details were published. It was mere minutes after those details were published that I recorded and put out the video, and since then, some more details have come to light. While there were 31 projects selected that were past rejected ideas projects to be made into LEGO Ideas sets, they have clarified that only 13 of these will actually be made. So there is, unfortunately, still a chance that the Bionicle project may still be denied after it goes through the revisions to make it to the final 13. However, I do have several reasons as to why I don't think that they will deny it, especially at this stage.
The main reason why I think this is because these 13 are literally just decided by the first 13 quickest to hit their crowdfunding goal. So basically, as long as Bionicle is among the top 13 designs to be quickly crowdfunded, then there's no way that the set does not get made. If the Bionicle community is as passionate about buying this as they were for voting for Bionicle in the original ideas phase, I see no reason as to why this will not be among the top 13 projects voted to become a set. Again, as long as it reaches its fundraising goal quickly, which it should relatively quickly do, then it will become a set. So really, while there of course is a small chance it does not become a set, I mean, as long as the Bionicle community actually votes for it and tries to pour money into it, then it will become a set, which I really do think will happen. So it's almost a certainty at this point, which is why I announce it as such. Of course, again, very, very minute chance that it will not become a set, but that's very, very small because it literally is just based on which will be the fastest to hit the crowdfunding goal, which I really do believe that this will hit.
But I just wanted to take a quick step back because I know a ton of people were a little bit confused on the previous video. I admit that I was very, very excited. I probably didn't explain this really all too well. So just for the people who have no idea what this is, how Bionicle is returning, let me just start off a few years back in 2019. So this was before Bricklink, which basically is the site to buy and sell used and new discontinued LEGO. Bricklink was not acquired by the LEGO Group in 2019. This was essentially the prelude to them being acquired. So Bricklink partnered with LEGO to introduce this thing called the A-Fold Designer Program. In this program, they selected a ton of A-Folds and had them submit their designs, designed via stud.io, which is Bricklink's online digital designer. After this design and review phase, a certain amount of these designs were accepted to be produced into actual, quote-unquote, official LEGO sets. While these sets were not sold in LEGO stores, nor were they sold on LEGO.com, you could only get them by purchasing them on Bricklink.com. However, they were basically legitimate LEGO sets. Both Brickset, which is an official LEGO set database, and, well, of course, Bricklink, list them as official LEGO sets, and they even came with an exclusive printed element celebrating the anniversary of Bricklink that LEGO produced for this program. So they're very much official sets. The only caveat was that they had to draw from a very limited pool of pieces. They had to basically use just some common modern pieces that were available, and they couldn't introduce any, of course, new molds or even new prints. Basically, everything had to be 100% vanilla from what you could build with standard LEGO pieces today. Unlike many other actual ideas projects, which now they made a new rule, they can get new molds, but almost certainly they get at least some part recolors and some reprints. These sets, once they were available from Bricklink, sold out very, very quickly, especially the more popular ones. It's actually one of my biggest LEGO regrets that I missed out on getting a bunch of these, because I figured I was gonna wait until I got some birthday money, which was a few days after these sets went live, and I was gonna spend some birthday money on buying these sets, and they sold out really fast. I only managed to get one, and to this day, I only still have that one, which is the Western Saloon, and I just very recently purchased one on the secondhand market, which was the Skyline Transport Monorail, for a lot more than it actually retailed for. So they were very, very limited, only a short run, and the other thing is that it took them ages to ship. I purchased mine in May of 2019, and I believe that I got it around November or December of 2019, so basically took the entire summer and a little bit of fall to get to me, and I think it's the same for this program as well. They announced that the 13 winning designs will be available for order on June 1st this year, and they will not ship until November 1st, and that's only the first batch. So basically, if you order it right on the dot, the earliest that you will get it is November 1st, which is fine. I mean, I don't mind waiting if it's Bionicle. And basically people who order it afterwards, if there's still some stock, it'll be shipping probably throughout next year. So it's kind of a 2021/2022 release cycle. So that brings us to this program. So basically, Bricklink got acquired by the LEGO Group. They are now officially a part of the LEGO Group. And they announced a few months ago that they would be bringing back rejected ideas projects and turning them into actual sets via the AFOL Designer program. This was really, really exciting news. I even made a whole video on it where I analyzed every single one of the previous rejected ideas sets and placed my bets on exactly which ones I thought would actually make it into this round. Back then, we didn't even know how many there would be. I just picked the top 10, but allegedly there's a lot more. So essentially, throughout this program, they basically surveyed all of the rejected previous LEGO ideas and picked everything that was non-licensed. So obviously they can't get any licenses for these. So everything non-licensed, they picked a pool of 31 ideas from rejected idea sets to be chosen to be considered to be remade into LEGO sets. Essentially, the designers have a window of time between now and in a few months. They essentially have to redesign their set to fit within Bricklink's parameters. Some of these include a parts cap at 4,000 pieces. They've got a lot of part restrictions. They have to build it digitally on stud.io. And in terms of the new prints, it appears that they cannot introduce any new prints whatsoever. Sokoda actually commented on our previous video, and he stated that not a lot of details are public as of right now. He doesn't really know himself, but he did include decals because he thought that maybe there's a chance that they could produce some stickers for the set, but that is still yet to be seen. We have no idea if these will actually be getting unique stickers. I have really no idea. I'm honestly surprised that that was even a consideration. I would have thought that Bricklink would have spelled it out to the designers if they could or could not include decals. But that's another story. Essentially, out of this pool of 31 projects that are being considered to be made into official LEGO sets, only 13 will be selected. And that's kind of the focus of today's video. I will be trying to pick out which 13 I feel personally are the most likely to be selected for this program, and which ones I feel don't really have too much of a chance. I'll also be investigating specifically Bionicle's chances, which I do, as I said, feel are pretty high, but definitely want to investigate that a little bit more. At the end of this video, hopefully, we'll have a list of the 13 most likely idea sets to be made into Bricklink AFOL Designer Program sets. Now, I just want to state that another question that a lot of people are asking in the previous video is that, is it just this one set? Is LEGO bringing back the entire theme? Where's Construction? So, no. This is literally just one set. The only reason why Bionicle is slash has a chance to be back is because Sokoda made the LEGO Ideas project in the past, submitted it for review, got to 10K supporters, and it was denied, it was rejected. And via this program, they are taking back rejected Ideas projects to turn them into actual sets. Sokoda's Bionicle project was lucky enough to be one of the 31 chosen. So as of right now, the only set that will be made for Bionicle in 2021 is potentially this set, and you must buy it on bricklink.com or else you will not be able to get it. A lot of other people have been asking, well, can we include any Construction elements or can we bring back Construction in some way? This is not really the right venue to do that. For one, basically all of the molds have been destroyed. Basically all the standard CCBS limb joints, shells, whatever you name it, sockets, have all been destroyed. The molds for them have been destroyed at this point. We do have confirmation on that. Unfortunately, really the only CCBS parts that remain are some of the beast feet, which are used in Ninjago Dragons, the friction piece, which is also used in Ninjago Dragons, and just a few of the Star Wars CCBS armor shells, which are still used in system sets. So in order to actually bring back Constraction, that would require a lot of new molds and a massive investment in money to be put into the theme, which is definitely not surrounding this venue. This is literally the cheapest way possible to produce rejected sets using existing pieces, which honestly, I'm okay with because it's better than nothing. Maybe if they actually revive Bionicle as a full-fledged theme, which is obviously the big dream, then yes, they probably would figure out something to do to bring back Constraction. But as of right now, this news is just pertaining to Sokoda's Bionicle project, which is purely built out of system. Now, I want to quickly give some reasons as to why it might be a good idea to support this, even if you're not the biggest fan of system. So personally, I'm obviously going to get this because I love both system and Bionicle, but for people who are just hardcore fans of Bionicle, really only like it for the action figures, I would actually recommend that if this goes on sale, obviously I'm not going to force you to buy anything, but I really would try to convince you, just try to get this one set to support Bionicle as a theme. I think that if we as a community show LEGO that Bionicle is viable, people are willing to buy Bionicle even if it's just a Bricklink AFOL designer program set using existing pieces built entirely out of system, I think that that will send the strongest message to LEGO that Bionicle is still viable as a full-fledged LEGO theme. So if you want Constraction back, if you want action figures back in full force, this is the first step that you can take to convince LEGO that there is consumer demand for this product. So I would actually recommend, if you're even just remotely a fan of Bionicle, even if you've never touched system before, just I'd recommend for you to get the set. Support Bionicle, support a great LEGO theme, and convince LEGO that Bionicle is still viable. But on that note, it's time to dive right into the analysis of these 31 sets. Up on screen right here, you can see all 31 of these sets, and we'll be talking about which ones I think are the most likely to be made into the 13 officially produced Bricklink AFOL designer sets. Let's go.
I just want to start off with a brief overview of all 31 approved projects for this phase. I'll be going through briefly each of them and describing their chances at becoming an actual set based on the crowd voting. The first one we have up here is the massive train station stud gate. This model was actually one that I did not believe would actually make it because the original proposal suggested recoloring some of the most discontinued and rarest large LEGO space canopies for the transparent clear windows. Thankfully, for this redesign to allow it to even be approved for this process, the designer has modified it to include only existing LEGO pieces. As such, I believe that this actually does have a pretty decent chance at being made, especially because it's been a while since LEGO train fans have gotten a massive train station, and we've never even gotten one this detailed. I really do appreciate the way that they utilize the garage door pieces, they work very well as windows, and the miniature train in the center is a very nice touch as well. Moving on from this model though, we can take a look at the Seasons in Time calendar. This model has yet to be updated for this review phase, although honestly, it doesn't look like there's too many things that specifically need to be updated for this. It seems like it's generally just using currently available pieces, so I can't imagine the designer having to modify it too much. What is nice about this one though is that they include these smaller dioramas depicting each of these seasons, which I do think is a pretty nice touch, although in terms of its chances for the competition, I'm not really sure if this one will stand out above the rest, because personally I think it would be quite expensive to include both this large centerpiece of a calendar that actually works and has all the internal mechanisms, plus all these little dioramas. I can't imagine someone willing to spend say $200+ on this versus say $200+ on the train station instead. Still, I could be surprised though, and we'll keep it in the bracket. Moving on though, we have this classic diner. This is a very charming, smaller model. It's actually one of the older LEGO Ideas projects that was rejected and then later revived for this program, but I actually can see this one being made pretty realistically, especially because it's not a subject matter that we normally see as a LEGO set, but it's also not too expensive, and people will be looking to purchase some of these smaller items. So I think that this one being priced at say $40 to $50, maybe even $60, could be a pretty good price point for it and could propel it forwards because it's one of the best smaller price sets. Moving on, we have the kakapo. It is an endangered species of bird that is depicted here in brick format, very similar to the original LEGO Birds idea set. Unfortunately though, in the past, the LEGO Birds idea set did not sell particularly well, and despite this one being relatively cheap, I can only imagine this being, say, $20 to $30, maybe $40 if they're really pushing it in price, I'm not really sure how well this one will fare, especially because there's frankly much more exciting things to be purchased from this lot. Moving on though to one that will almost certainly be made and one I am very, very excited for, this is the castle in the forest. This one is basically another one of those models that generally doesn't seem like it uses any non-production pieces, which makes it pretty prime for being used for this program. It's already been redesigned to fit this program specifically, and I can very easily see this one almost certainly making it as an actual set, especially because there are so many castle fans who would want it. I, for one, will be definitely purchasing this the moment it comes online. Moving on, we have the Winter Chalet. This is a very old ideas project that reached 10K several years ago. It's supposed to be an entry into the Winter Village line. I do think it's a pretty charming build, and it's really nice how the designer has redesigned it for this program. Unfortunately though, I do feel like it is a little bit of a more simplistic design, especially when compared to many of the other designs that could be chosen in this bracket. I also do feel like the Winter Village theme is at this point a little bit oversaturated, so I'm not entirely sure if this one stands a major chance at being accepted, specifically because people can get a very similar set by buying any one of the Winter Village sets that currently exist. Moving on, we have the working LEGO waterfall. This one actually includes some motors, and basically the function works by studs dropping back and forth through the clear panes of the waterfall. It's a pretty interesting function, but unfortunately, again, I'm not entirely sure on this one what its chances are, especially because really it doesn't do too much. It is very loud, and all it does is really just have the studs go down the waterfall. It's definitely a well-built feature, and the rock work is really well done. I just am not sure how well this will fare against the other ones, especially because the price will probably be increased a little bit because of the fact that it has all the motors inside. Next up, we have the Fishing Dive Shop. This is one out of three fishing-related building models in this review period, and there's another fishing boat as well, so I guess that makes four. Clearly, it's a topic that a lot of AFOLs have been looking for. Again, this is one of the older models that got approved for this phase, and while it is pretty charming, I will say that we basically got the same exact thing in the old fishing store LEGO Ideas set. I'm not entirely sure if people who own that set will be willing to spend this amount of money for basically a very similar building, or maybe they'll be more willing to spend it on other stuff. I'm sure that at least one of these fishing-themed ideas will make it through, but all three, I'm not so sure. We'll talk about that more when we get to the rankings. Moving on though, we have this expertly designed fishing boat. I'm actually quite excited about this one because LEGO doesn't typically do large-scale boats, and I feel like this is filling a niche that a lot of LEGO collectors have been looking for. It's very well designed and is definitely something very different than we normally get, which isn't necessarily a bad thing because it really will stand out among the crowd. I think this one has a pretty decent chance at being one of the top 13 to be funded. Next up, we have, of course, probably the reason why many of you are watching this video, the Legend of the Bionicle. This was Sokoda's project to celebrate Generation 1 of the Bionicle storyline. You'll notice that he has redesigned it to not include any new minifigures. Instead, it just includes new stickers, which he's still not even sure if it can even have any of these stickers. There's a high chance that the model will be released with no decals whatsoever, which I do honestly feel will still work for this design, because the focus isn't really on the decals. It's more about the depictions being shown in this build here. Obviously, you don't need the decals to immediately recognize as a Bionicle fan which of these builds are what. So honestly, I do feel like this has an incredibly strong chance at being one of the top 13. We've seen the power of the Bionicle community coming out in waves to vote for the set. Now it's just time for them to put their money where their mouth is and really just go out and start crowdfunding this set as soon as it becomes available for release. Next up, we have the Old Wild West Saloon. This was originally proposed as a movie set, although it seems like it's been modified slightly just specifically to focus mostly on the saloon aspect. It still does have the movie set features. You can see it has some fun features where it explodes, gets blasted out, and it does have the film and set equipment, but I'm not sure exactly how much of that will be retained for the final product. That being said though, this one does feel remarkably similar to the previous Wild West Saloon that we actually got via the AFOL Designer program. However, it is very rare that we get Western-themed LEGO sets, so maybe the fans will be willing to head on out one more time to support this one in the process. I, for one, would definitely want to purchase this, I just am not sure if it'll hit the top 13. We'll discuss this a little more when we get to rankings. Moving on to here, we have the Space Troopers idea. This is a very interesting one because it originally was proposed as a brand new LEGO theme, back when LEGO Ideas restrictions were still a little bit lax and they were allowing submissions like this to propose an entire wave of sets. I was shocked to see that this one actually got approved for the process, and it makes sense because it's been redesigned completely. Instead of featuring new molds and new minifigures and a host of different sets, they've essentially just focused on the largest mothership set, which retains some of the classic space LEGO decaling. This is the closest thing we're getting to a classic space set in the modern era. You can see the yellow, the gray, and the blue, so I can definitely see this one having a very, very strong chance, and I certainly would want more classic LEGO space or even just original LEGO space ideas, so I really do think that this one has a strong chance of being accepted. Moving on, we've got the Pursuit of Flight. This is an amazing kinetic model by JK Brickworks. He's a very famous LEGO mock designer who is very well known for making sculptures like these, which actually move. Turning the crank in the back allows the planes to swing back and forth, which is an incredible feature, and you can even swap the different planes out to represent some of the classic LEGO plane models that came out in the years past, from the 2012 Sopwith Camel to the Red Baron and the Wright Flyer from 2002 and 2003. There's a lot of vintage models represented here, even Amelia Earhart's Flyer, which was a recent GWP, so definitely some classic LEGO love. The big question is though, will this actually get enough supporters to beat out some of the larger entries? And that I'm a little bit skeptical on, but we'll have to wait and see. Moving on to the next entry, we have the Working Hadron Collider. In my initial review, I in fact wasn't even sure if they could make this into a set because I wasn't sure if it counted as licensed. Apparently it does not, so this one was passed through the approval phase. However, I'm not entirely sure how much of a chance this model has compared to the other ones, especially because unfortunately it's not as visually interesting as some of the other models, and I'm not entirely sure who the audience of this is for. I certainly would love a model like this, I think it's pretty interesting, but I'm not sure if the general AFOL audience will be willing to get this. Moving on, we have the Modular Style LEGO Store. This is pretty interesting. We've gotten a few LEGO stores in the past, but never to this degree. It even features a back worker's storeroom area, which is pretty fun. The big question is, are these models going to have stickers? I would assume so, because you can't really get that massive LEGO logo without having a sticker, so they probably wouldn't have approved this if you couldn't. That being said though, I'm not entirely sure how popular this model will be compared to the rest, especially as we've gotten physical depictions of LEGO stores in set format before, albeit not this complex. Next up, we have a very unique and original idea. This is the Ruined House. It depicts a broken down, dilapidated house using some very unique building techniques that really make this stand out as a very incredible display piece. That being said, I'm not entirely sure how likely people are to be supporting a very expensive ruined house set, probably around $150 to $200 just by looking at the scale of this, over some of the other large models, but it's definitely in the running. Let's talk about this more when we get to the rankings. Moving on, we have the LEGO Observatory Mountain View. This is a great building that depicts an observatory on the top of a mountain. Very unique build, I will say, and it's definitely well built, especially around the dome. Again though, not entirely sure how popular this one will be compared to the rest, especially with so many other powerhouse ideas, but we'll keep it in the running just in case. Moving on, we have the Steampunk Exploratorium. I have no idea how they're going to make this into an actual feasible model without introducing any recolors, which they can't, but apparently they will. Obviously, this model is still unchanged from the original idea, so basically it's still using a ton of non-production parts at the moment, ton of recolors that no longer exist, even some discontinued pieces. It's definitely gonna have to be significantly modified for the final set, but this is certainly a day one purchase for me. I've been dying to get any sort of LEGO steampunk build, and this looks incredible. I'm super excited for the set, and I really do hope it stands a good chance, especially because we rarely ever get LEGO steampunk related buildings before, and this is a feature focused set. That being said, it's probably going to be $200 to $300 just by looking at the scale, so I'm not really sure how popular this will be, but at least my fingers are crossed because I really want this set. Moving on, we have got the modular construction site. This is basically a modular building being built. This is a pretty unique idea, I will say, although we have basically gotten similar things before. We've gotten a crane of about this scale in the past for LEGO City, and of course we've gotten modular buildings far more interesting than this pretty bare bones construction site. I'm not sure how popular this will be, and I'm kind of curious as to why they chose this over many of the other modular buildings that have been proposed and rejected by LEGO Ideas. Typically, I didn't even think any modular buildings would make it through at all because that's LEGO's own thing, but if you're gonna accept a modular building, I kind of question why they did the one that's partially constructed and has a crane besides it, which probably makes it even bigger than some of the other modulars. That being said though, it's still pretty unique, and I know a lot of people have been wanting complex and unique modulars, so maybe this stands a decent chance. I just don't know. Moving on, we have the Clockwork Aquarium. The fish will swim as you turn the crank, which is a pretty fun feature. I really do like the way that this is built, and it looks like you can generally build this out of existing pieces. This will definitely be another one of these smaller sets, probably $20 to $30 at most. The big question again is that will people support this over some of the larger stuff? I'm not so sure. Moving on, we have this fantasy mountain windmill type set. It's very unique and actually is probably only going to be probably around $80 to $100. I can definitely see this one being accepted, especially because it kind of hits that castle fantasy niche. It's very much a unique build and one that I was really suspecting would make it through the original review when I did my first video. So I definitely can see this one actually being made as a set, which will definitely be a purchase for me. Moving on, we have the working LEGO safe. I was pretty shocked to see this one approved because it has a brick-built LEGO revolver as well as a brick-built LEGO alcohol or beer bottle and as well as some brick-built dynamite. So kind of surprised to see this one actually being approved as a set to be potentially made for this program. I guess they were just looking for smaller sets to appease that smaller price point market, but kind of an interesting one. The function actually being fully working is pretty neat, I will have to say. Again, though, I'm not really sure if people will be supporting this over some of the more exciting, larger sets. Moving on, we have the Anatomini. This one actually was within the review process for several years. They were trying to see if they could make this set. It kept on being pushed back and back until eventually LEGO realized that they could not feasibly make this into an actual set. Which is why, to my surprise, it was actually accepted for this program. So I guess that they are actually deciding that they can make it into an actual set, which is definitely a surprise. This one seems like it should be pretty popular, and I've seen a lot of people online wanting this model. It's a pretty unique one to me. I have no idea how they're going to make it stable at all, because essentially it's just super hollow on the inside, and that Technic frame for the skeleton doesn't look too stable either. So I'm not really sure how they're actually going to pull this off as a working LEGO set, but apparently it's going to happen. So actually, I do really think that this does stand a decent chance, because a lot of people do want it. I just thought it wouldn't be possible. Moving on, we have the very Oriental-inspired Temple of Hermit. Just from what I've seen online, a lot of people are really excited about this one, including myself. I would love to own this. This looks really, really great. I am almost 100% sure this one will be approved, which makes me very happy because this one will fit well against any sort of Oriental, Asian-inspired diorama. Even LEGO Ninjago sets would look good next to it. So definitely a fantastic build and one of the most complex temples LEGO would have ever done, especially surpassing the Temple of Erijutsu from Ninjago. Moving on, we have the Boathouse Diner. This is a very fun design, kind of similar to the fishing stores, except this actually has some sort of decoration of a pirate ship or a boat sticking out of the side. Because of that, I feel like this one is probably the most likely idea to be accepted out of all of the boathouse slash fishing models, because it's simply the most well-constructed and the most visually interesting and unique. I'll certainly be buying the set, and I'll be putting my money where my mouth is, because I'll be pre-ordering this immediately. Next up, we have the relatively smaller set, Science Adventures. Now, unfortunately, I'm not really sure how much of a chance this one will have. The previous Research Institute set did not sell very well for LEGO Ideas, and this one is pretty simple. I don't really see this one standing a major chance, especially because of how small and simplistic it is. So unfortunately, not really sure if this one will make it through, but I'll still put it on the list for comparison anyways. Moving on, we have Japanese Architecture as a LEGO set. This one proposes several different temples and palaces built with Japanese architecture. However, I do think that the Temple of Hermit kind of has this beat both in presentation and build quality. This was a very old model that was just recently approved for this review process, so I'm not really sure how much it'll improve by the final model, but again, it's pretty simplistic, the pictures are pretty basic of it. Maybe it'll go through a drastic upgrade for the next review phase, but I'm not so sure, and I can definitely see the Temple of Hermit beating this one out. Moving on, we have the Bowling Alley. I know also a lot of people are excited about this, including myself. I think this has a pretty decent chance at being made because it's just such a unique structure for LEGO to do, and while LEGO themselves may not actually produce this, if it's through the fundraising campaign, I can definitely see people wanting to buy it. So I can think this one has a pretty good chance. It has fully working bowling lanes too, which is a major plus. Moving on, we have some Venetian architecture. Now, I personally am very interested in this set. I would love to have this as an actual set. That being said, though, I do think that there are more exciting, larger scale models. These ones are relatively simplistic, being just rectangular boxes with house-shaped formations, so not really sure if this one will be picked as one of the top 13, but I definitely may even try to reproduce this myself because they will be posting building instructions, because I do actually think it's a pretty decent build, and it really is reminiscent of Venice. Moving on, we have the Boat Repair Shop. Yet again, one of the other diving slash fishing boat shop set ideas that have been made for ideas. Again, I think this one's going to get beat out by the restaurant, to be honest. It's also very similar to the old fishing store, so not really sure how much of a chance this has. Although the one pretty unique feature is the boat on rails to allow it to slide into the water. That's a pretty fun feature, in my opinion. And finally, the last setup is Quest Builder. So this is some sort of a D&D campaign-esque LEGO set. They essentially have all these modules that you can create your own dungeons and have different minifigures travel through the dungeons to try to accomplish different goals, almost like a large-scale board game where minifigures are the players. However though, this will probably be pretty expensive, probably around the $200, maybe $150 range, and again, out of all the large ideas, this one definitely doesn't seem like a major one that people will be really clamoring for, so I don't think this one has a major chance, but we'll still compare it alongside the rest as usual. Whew, alright, okay, well with all 31 projects reviewed, it is now time to take a look at which ones I feel are the most likely to become the 13 quickest funded ideas. So here we have an image of all 31 projects together. Let's just start trying to rule out some of them until we get down to the top 13. First of all, I do think that out of all the fishing slash dive store ideas, the restaurant is the most viable, and I can definitely see people clamoring for that one over these relatively more simplistic ideas. So let's rule out the dive shop and the docks here. Unfortunately, there are nice builds, but I do think they'll be beat out by the restaurant. Moving on, I think that, again, as I just mentioned, the Quest Builder will be a hard sell at a high price point, so I definitely can see that getting funded a little bit slower. And then we can rule out a lot of these smaller ideas, because I feel like people will be more willing to put their money into larger LEGO ideas. Specifically, the Kakapo, despite being a really well-built model, I do think definitely doesn't have a major chance of being approved. And then we've got Science Adventures. Again, the original version of it didn't sell too well. Don't really see that one selling too well either. Working Aquarium has a fun function, but again, isn't really that visually engaging compared to the rest. We've got the LEGO Safe, the combination safe here, which again, I also feel like maybe will be lost in the shuffle a little bit out of the best ideas. And then the Working Waterfall, I think the function is a little less impressive than people may think, so it's not a major design. Moving on, the next ones that we can rule out are some of the larger models. It's getting a little bit harder to rule these out, but again, I think the modular construction building is a little bit too different of a modular to do. The building itself isn't too visually interesting, so I can definitely see people wanting different things other than that, because again, we do get modulars all the time anyway. The same kind of goes for the Venetian buildings. They are just rectangular buildings after all, which is a shame, but not really sure if that one really stands a big chance. Some of the other ones here that are relatively larger, but I also don't think have a major chance, are the observatory, just because there's more interesting stuff to do for the LEGO Ideas round here. The Japanese architecture, unless significantly improved, doesn't stand up against the Temple of Hermit. The Hadron Collider will be pretty expensive and doesn't have a major audience. And the Seasons in Time calendar also will be very expensive and will likely be beat out by some of the larger ideas. And man, it's getting harder and harder to start ruling out these ideas. I just really wish they would produce all of them, because I would love to build all of these models. But if we had to remove a few more, I think the Ruined House, unfortunately, it's a really cool concept, a really cool build. I think probably the subject matter will be off-putting to some. Maybe some will kind of find it strange, like why would they want to display a ruined house? So maybe I can see that one not making it through. The Winter Chalet is probably too similar to previous Winter Village sets, so I don't see that one making it through either. We've got the Pursuit of Flight, which is a very fun mechanism, but again, one of the smaller ones, which I'm not sure will stand a chance against the rest. And the Modular LEGO Store, which is a really great build, but again, I feel like people won't be willing to spend that much on a LEGO store, especially when you can buy pre-existing LEGO store sets already, and there's more interesting stuff. And with that, we are left with 13 ideas that I do believe are the most likely ideas to be funded first in the crowdfunding phase. These are the Legend of the Bionicle, the Exploratorium, the Fishing Boat, the Retro Diner, the Bowling Alley, Space Troopers, the Mountain Windmill, the Saloon, the Boathouse Diner, the Temple of Hermit, the Castle in the Forest, Train Station Studgate, and Anatomini. I will certainly be pre-ordering all 13 of these sets as soon as they become available. I will make sure that I will be putting my money exactly into these 13, because I do feel like these are the most likely 13, and I think it'll be a pretty fun thing that when the results come out, when the final 13 are out, I'm going to revisit this video and see how many I got right, how many I got wrong, and if I was crazily off on some of them. For example, some of the earliest ones that I ruled out, maybe those ones might, to my surprise, be actually made into sets. But taking a closer look at this range of sets, I do really feel like this range has a little bit of something for everyone. The Exploratorium fills the steampunk niche a lot of people have been wanting, the Train Station does the same for LEGO Trains, and people love LEGO Castle and fantasy stuff, so hence the windmill and the castle I think stand a chance. The Western Saloon is another one that people have been wanting, especially because LEGO probably won't make Western sets anymore. Obviously, there's major interest in the dive shop slash marina locations, buildings, ideas. So, of course, the fishing boat, I think, is unique that we'll get through, as well as the boat diner, which I think we'll definitely get through as well because of the major interest in these models. Obviously, a lot of people have been wanting LEGO Space back. So this classic space-inspired build for Space Troopers, I think, has a pretty good shot. For people interested in more oriental architecture, the Temple of Hermit is a fantastic build that a lot of people have been wanting, myself included. For more retro throwback stuff or regular city stuff, we've got the Retro Diner, which I think is a pretty fun smaller model, as well as the Bowling Alley, which is also pretty unique as well. Of course, for people wanting something very different, the Anatomini is a very interesting sculpture for a LEGO set, which definitely has been approved many times. People definitely want to see this as a set, so I can see it being funded because it's very unique. And finally, of course, the Legend of the Bionicle. If the Bionicle fan community doesn't come together and make this one of the top 13 models to get approved, let's just say I'll be beyond disappointed. Come on. If you're interested remotely in Bionicle, please, please buy this set, because that will mean it gets made. The set will not get made unless you crowdfund it, and crowdfund it fast. So I definitely really, really think that this one hopefully has a major chance, and depending on the hype levels, come on, I think Bionicle fans can not only make this within the top 13 models, I think they can make this the top, number one, fastest to be funded model. But that's a discussion for another day, and I'll definitely be making a lot of videos reminding people for that.
Let me know down in the comments below, do you agree or disagree with my choices here? What choices would you pick? And again, I want to reiterate, these are not my personal choices for what I personally want to see as sets. These are the ones that I feel are most likely to become sets. That's all I have for today. Thank you all for tuning into Duck Bricks, and stay tuned for even more LEGO news, reviews, discussion, and analyses coming your way very soon. Thanks all for watching, and bye-bye for now.